Dan Walker and his Strictly dance partner Nadiya Bychkova's glamour as they stepped out after filming It Takes Two in London on Friday. The BBC breakfast journalist, 44, donned an eye-catching dark purple velvet tuxedo with a matching bow tie. Nadiya, meanwhile, 32, looked stunning as she donned a striking scarlet gown which had a deep plunging neckline. Nadiya's bright blonde hair was swept back into a low ponytail with two strands left to frame her face. She wore square hoop earrings in her lobes, and carried her phone in her hand which was in a black sparkly case. Dan put his hand on his dance partner's back as they left the TV studio. The dancing duo looked in high spirits as they arrived to the show earlier in the day. The professional dancer wore a beige wool double-breasted coat paired with knee-high boots. Her blonde tresses were tied back in a low ponytail as she stepped into the venue with Dan, who looked casual wearing a navy blue puffer jacket and jogging bottoms. The pair took to the floor with a quick step last Saturday to one of the breakfast host's favorite songs, "Everybody Needs Somebody to Love" by the Blues Brothers. Despite the judges' open admittance they did not have high hopes, Dan was praised for giving the dance his absolute best, and he later revealed he had dedicated the routine to his former co-host Louise Minchin, after she departed breakfast last week. Anton said, "I have to be honest, I was a bit nervous about this. I thought you were going to be awful, but you were terrific. I love your energy. You covered the floor brilliantly. I just want you to work on your arms. Your arm line has got to be carried a bit more forward, just hold her a bit further away, but otherwise tremendous." Dan was then treated to a video message from his former co-host Louise, who said, "Hi Dan, I cannot believe you dedicated your first dance on Strictly to me. I really miss you on the breakfast show, but I'm so excited to watch you every Saturday night. Thank you, good luck and have fun." Strictly continues this Saturday on BBC One.